Scientist Seth Brundle thinks he is about to master a revolutionary concept in transportation, the instantaneous transmission of a human being through space. But Seth Brundle is not alone. The brilliant scientist has instead mastered another revolutionary concept, genetic fusion. He will soon become a hideous mutant. Seth Brundle's bizarre and terrifying metamorphosis is the subject of 20th Century Fox's remake of the 1958 classic, The Fly.
How you doing? Now you tell me. Am I different somehow?
It's a nightmare. I mean, it's a movie that tells a story about a guy who is beginning to change, and he can exercise no control over that change.
All right, quiet, please.
There's a reflection right over her face from this angle right now.
Directed by David Cronenberg, who's known for horrific thrillers like The Dead Zone, Videodrome, and Scanners, this version of The Fly is based on an entirely different premise than the original film.
In the original, a man and a fly basically switch heads, and you have this sort of instant monster created. In this film, when he comes out of the receiving pod, he is perfectly normal. But the fly has disappeared. His body has assimilated the fly, and more than that, it has fused with the fly on a genetic level. And then gradually he begins to realize that he's not turning into a 185-pound fly, but in fact is turning into a creature that never really existed before.
Jeff Goldblum, who starred in The Big Chill, portrays the scientist Seth Brundle. He's on the verge of his scientific breakthrough when he falls in love with science journalist Veronica Quaife, played by Gina Davis.
Listen, maybe this is a bad idea.
Oh, it's too late. You've already seen them. Can't let you leave here alive.
It's a story about somebody who loves life and who loves this girl, and something awful happens to him, and he's going to die, and he's going to become something else, and he's trying to make the most out of what his life can be.
You're changing, Seth.
That's silly. That's ridiculous.
Something happened when you went through, Seth. You've got to get some help. I think you must be sick.
You're jealous!
Take out the fact that he has an accident with a fly and imagine that he just gets cancer or some terrible disfiguring disease. And what happens to a relationship when that happens? How do you withstand the pressure and you still love someone, but they're turning into something you don't understand and becoming someone you don't know anymore? Mm.
Hey, what's this?
It's an attempt to distract me, that's what it is.
No, really, what is this? It's like hairs or something.
Brundle's transformation from a man to an insect-like creature is a slow and insidious one. Chris Whalas, who brought Steven Spielberg's Gremlins to life, created each phase of Goldblum's metamorphosis.
We're taking a main character and bringing him from a very, very human form all the way through subtle skin color changes to sores and creating, finally, him in his stage that's just horribly degenerated, and then pass that to another stage, which is an entirely new being.
It does finally get claustrophobic. You could kind of freak out. I mean, you're covered in this thing, and it's exhausting too. Not only you're in this thing and it's kind of very hot, but in part of the makeup, my whole there's kind of this weight on my eyes all the time, and to kind of see, I have to keep doing that. You know, so it's very, very exhausting.
Seth?
No, up here.
Oh.
Eventually, the creature is able to crawl up walls and across the ceiling. To create this illusion, director Cronenberg had a special set built.
There really is only one respectable way to do that, and that is to build a set that actually revolves. As he's walking, the ceiling becomes the floor, and the camera ultimately ends up upside down with the cameraman, and we have our actor on the what looks like the ceiling, but in fact is the floor. At this point, the fly is very messy. And he likes to eat things that are sugary and sweet, and so we have donuts and decaying rolls and all kinds of stuff all over the place. And all of these have to be nailed and bolted and glued down so that when the set turns upside down, everything just doesn't fall and reveal what's going on. So it's actually very, very tricky to do. So I would say the detailing of what happens to the relationships and to this man physically and emotionally I could tell you about it for days, and you still, I think, would not be prepared for what happens to him in the film.
It's your turn.
No, I don't want to try that.
Okay, that's it. You're going to like it.
I don't want to. I'm afraid.
Don't be afraid.
No, be afraid. Be very afraid.
It's a nightmare. I mean, it's a movie that tells a story about a guy who is beginning to change, and he can exercise no control over that change.
In the original, a man and a fly basically switch heads, and you have this sort of instant monster created. In this film, when he comes out of the receiving pod, he is perfectly normal. But the fly has disappeared. And what's happened is that there's been his body has assimilated the fly, and more than that, it has fused with the fly on a genetic level. And then gradually he begins to realize that he is in fact transforming into something that has never really existed before. It's not a big fly, as he says. He's not turning into a 185-pound fly, but in fact is turning into a creature that never really existed before. There really is only one respectable way to do that, and that is to build a set that actually revolves as he's walking. The ceiling becomes the floor, and the camera ultimately ends up upside down with the cameraman, and we have our actor on the what looks like the ceiling but in fact is the floor. At this point, the fly is very messy, and he likes to eat things that are sugary and sweet, and so we have donuts and decaying rolls and all kinds of stuff all over the place, and all of these have to be nailed and bolted and glued down so that when the set turns upside down, everything just doesn't fall and reveal what's going on. So it's actually very, very tricky to do. Ironically enough, I think that the things that people will say are very Cronenberg when they see the film are in fact the things that were in the script that I was given. That was one of the great shocks, pleasant shocks, that I had when I read the script that was handed to me by Mel Brooks. There were details of this transformation of the main character which felt like things that I could have written myself. I've done films that are primarily action, like Scanners, and I've done films that are primarily character, like The Dead Zone, and I've done films that are very quite deeply into special effects that have never been done before, like Videodrome. And I think in The Fly, all of these things are combined. One of the things that I like about making movies is the surprises that come up.
It's a story finally about somebody who loves life and who loves this girl, and something awful happens to him, and he's going to die, and he's going to become something else, and he's trying to just make the most out of what his life can be. It does finally get claustrophobic, you know, and you want to, you could kind of freak out. I mean, you're covered in this thing, and it's exhausting too. Not only you're in this thing and it's kind of very hot, but in part of the makeup, my whole, there's kind of this weight on my eyes all the time, and to kind of see, I have to keep doing that, you know, so it's very, very exhausting, I'll say. And I got the idea that he had a personal interest in and vision for these weird and bizarre and horrible stories. One of the reasons I wanted to be an actor, and one of the things I knew about me being an actor was going to include being alive, being lively. That's what acting is for and about. It enhances life. It's a lively experience. It intensifies life, and that's good. I wanted that. I'd put out 5 hours of makeup on, and I was sort of naked, essentially, except I've got, you know, foam rubber glued all over me. And they built this wall, this brick wall, kind of at about this angle, very steep, 4 stories high. And I climbed all the way to the top of it, and the makeup man greased me up all over with KY jelly. At the end of the day, they said they'd used 55 tubes of KY jelly. And on action, I jump backwards on my hands and knees on the wall and slide very fast down the 4 stories, and at the bottom, slam myself into this wall of metal. And they say, cut, and they sort of, the crew's going to clap, and they say, okay, that was fine, Jeff, okay, well, you do it again. And I did it all day long. There were, like, times on this movie where I said to myself, you're a good sport. I guess you'll do anything.
Take out the fact that it's a fly, so that he has an accident with a fly, and imagine that he just gets cancer or some terrible disfiguring disease, and what happens to a relationship when that happens? How do you withstand the pressure and you still love someone, but they're turning into something you don't understand and becoming someone you don't know anymore? People ask what he's like because he's made these kind of gory films. And they think, wow, is he just crazy or a weird guy or what? But he's the opposite of what you might think he'd be like, very calm and laid back and together and kind of a regular guy, like a nice regular guy. David Cronenberg teased me about that too. He would call me the girl. He'd say, get the girl. Let's do the girl shot now. Because in a lot of those films, it is the girl. You need like the girl who comes in and goes, ah! And screams, and you need just a good screamer and somebody can kind of look good. And I like doing comedy very much. I don't mind at all if people think I'm good at comedy. That would be great. I didn't approach this part. It is sort of my first big, serious, dramatic part and everything, but I didn't approach it like that. I was afraid a little bit if I did, it would come out like, Gina Davis trying to be serious. And you know how people sometimes do that when they're acting? They attempt a different role, and they think, suddenly, I can't be, I have to be totally humorless, and I have to be very straight. And so there are a lot of funny parts in the movie, I think, and even more than we anticipated. Establishing how much we love each other before the accident became very important to us, because if you didn't believe that we really loved each other more than any couple ever has before this accident happens, why would I really stick around when I go, this is really strange, and I hope it all works out for you.